Hello and welcome to another edition of All About Apps from the Cleveroad studio. It's good to see you all again. Today we're discussing design. We're going to find out about wireframes, mockups and prototyping. We'll also discover how they serve to perfect the design. The interesting thing is that there are different points of view concerning these concepts. If you ask Google about the differences between them, you'll receive literally hundreds of thousands of results. Having read all the information, you may still be unclear about what they are. At Cleveroad, we have worked on numerous wireframes, mockups, and prototypes. Based on our experience, we'd like to share our vision on the topic. So, first of all, what is a wireframe? Well, it's a kind of draft of the product. A wireframe introduces the general scheme of the app or site and shows the layout of its components. It is usually the first step in the design process. Wireframes may differ depending on the level of detail. However, all of them reflect a basic view of the app or site, showing the intended placement of buttons, tabs, icons, and other elements. When you make the wireframe, consider the end user. That is, as if you were making it for your own use. It doesn't need lots of detail, but if a whole team is going to work from it or you intend to introduce it to a client, then a formal style and detailed view are preferred. Before you begin wireframing, try to answer the following questions. Which UI elements are the most important for the user? Which elements are of secondary consideration? How are they going to be arranged? What content will appear on the page? All in all, you'll see that wireframes help organize data and clearly show the app to be displayed on a certain app screen or website page. You might decide to omit wireframing if you're working on a very simple or short-lived project. If this is not the case, then approach the task with great care. Let's proceed to the next stage of design, which is about creating a mockup. Not only will you understand how the objects are going to be arranged, but see their shapes, fonts, and sometimes colors. If wireframes tend to skip all the tiny details, mockups, on the other hand, aim to fully illustrate them. You should think of a mockup as a static representation of the final product. It is not just a blueprint, but the finished look of the application or website. Here, the designer decides on the button names, icon forms, font sizes, and types. They also set the spacing between the elements and determine the intervals and gaps. Wording and terminology are being selected at this stage. Also, the designer starts choosing images that will appear on the site. Before you start working on a mockup, find the answers to the following questions. Which color grade is to be applied? How will the navigation be organized? What input fields, search symbols, menu buttons, and other components are currently missing? What is the common theme of your app or site? Mockups help decide between alternatives of the final product representation. If possible, produce several different options to choose from and make a final decision in collaboration with the client and team. When the mockup is ready, it's time to create a prototype. You might be wondering whether or not this is required. In design theory, the word prototype has a specific meaning. Its roots come from the Latin. Proto meaning origin and typus meaning form or model. If we talk about the prototype for a mobile application or website, what we mean is not just a static picture, but an interactive model that can show particular results depending on the actions taken. The prototype might not be exactly the same as the real app or site. However, it should be very close. This is definitely not a black and white drawing, but a faithful copy of the product that's going to be deployed by your customers. To make the process of prototyping clear, try to answer the following questions. How will the users interact with your product? What is the sequence of changing screens or pages? What can be done in order to optimize the user experience? Are there any better alternatives for representing a particular option? Prototyping is the best way to show your client how the final product is going to look and function. It faithfully displays all the vital options and demonstrates its visual representation. I hope by now that you have a better idea about the concepts of wireframing, mockups, and prototypes, and have a clearer view of how they differ and relate to each other. Note that there are many automatic tools to help in their creation. If you want a list, follow the link below to read the full Cleveroad article. I'll see you all next time with another exciting topic from the world of mobile applications. Stay healthy and don't forget to subscribe.